Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. This is the first video of the series on how to access your NAS and other network services remotely from anywhere in the world without compromising the security. I did create a video on the subject a while back using Cloudflare tunnels, but I guess that needs a refresh as well. So this series will contain tutorials on Tailscale, OpenVPN, and Cloudflare tunnels. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to add any other method in the series to remotely access your network services. In today's video, we'll talk about Tailscale. How can we set it up and use it to remotely access a NAS and other devices on the same network? For this tutorial, you'll need to have a Synology NAS. If you do not have a Synology NAS, I have created a video on how you can make your old PC a Synology NAS and install DSM on it. I'll leave the link to that video down in the description below. We will install Tailscale in our Synology NAS and configure it in a way to access the NAS just like we are sitting at our home, and then we will use it to access other devices on our network. I'll not go into the details for how Tailscale works. There are many videos from the subject matter experts on this topic. In layman's word, it's a networking tool that simplifies the process of setting up a secure and private network. It uses a technology called WireGuard to create a mesh VPN, allowing devices to connect directly to each other over the internet while maintaining a high level of security. So this is not a VPN service like Nord or Surfshark, where your public IP address changes and you can hide yourself from your ISP. This is the application of a traditional VPN, which is used to connect two networks or device with a network. But unlike a central VPN hub, which has to manage all the traffic, this will create a mesh network, where all the clients can talk directly to each other, which speeds up the communication. It's secure, fast, and most importantly, it's ridiculously easy to set up. You don't have to perform any port forwarding or manage any firewall. It will manage all the tricky bits to create and manage a secure VPN, including authentications. Alright, enough of talking. I'll leave the link to the blog post if you want to know more about Tailscale. Let's start the tutorial. First step is to install Tailscale on your Synology NAS from Package Center. You should be able to install it on most of the Synology NAS models. There's a list of supported Synology NAS models which support Tailscale. I'll leave the link to that list down in the description below. So go to Package Center and scroll down to third-party packages and install Tailscale from there. If you have a firewall enabled on your Synology NAS, you'll have to open the ports for Tailscale. Once the installation is complete, start the Tailscale package. You'll have to authenticate with Tailscale server. That means you'll have to create an account with Tailscale. Tailscale doesn't manage logins or two-factor authentications. These are all outsourced to identity providers like Google, Microsoft, or Apple. So you can sign in with any of these identity providers. Multi-factor authentication will work for the ID providers you use if you have already set it up on your account. I have already authenticated my Google account, so I'll log in again here. Once you are in, click Connect and you should see a confirmation message, and that should take you to your admin portal. Here you'll see your own private network called Tailnet. You should see the IP address to access your NAS, and that's basically it. No fancy configs are required. All you need now is to install Tailscale client on any of your devices and access your NAS using the IP address you see on the screen. Let's test it. My computer does not have a Tailscale client installed yet, so I'll try to access my NAS using the IP address under Tailnet. It will time out because my PC currently cannot see my NAS Tailnet IP address. Alright, now let's download and install TailScale client on my PC. Then I'll authenticate it with same Tailnet, currently my NAS isn't, and then it'll test it again. So go to Downloads and select Windows. Download the client and install it. Installation process is very simple, so once the installation completes, you'll be asked to authenticate. You can manually do that from the taskbar also. Once that's done, now I can see two machines under my account. One is the NAS and the other one is my PC. Since I have added my PC into my network where my NAS is, so now if I'll try to access my NAS using the IP address assigned by the Tailnet, it should work. You might have to add allow rule to access your NAS in your Synology firewall if you have enabled it. Alright, I can now access my NAS. So as you can see how easy it is to enable remote access of your NAS using TailScale. This is very reliable, fast and super secure remote connection to your NAS. Now let's go one step further and set it up to access other devices on same local network. To achieve this, using TailScale will make our Synology NAS a subnet router, which will act as a gateway for us to access other devices on the same subnet. This is especially handy if you want to access a device where you cannot install the TailScale client application. For example, my Unified Dream Machine Pro. To set up our NAS as a subnet router, we'll have to SSH into it. So I'll go ahead and enable SSH. Once that's done, open command prompt on Windows or terminal on your Mac and type SSH space your admin username at your Synology IP address. Hit enter and then enter the password. Once you are in, copy the command I have left in the description and paste it in the command prompt. So basically what this command is doing is just advertising the whole subnet. So that will open the whole entire subnet for us to access through the NAS. In my case, it's 192.168.10. This is the subnet my Synology NAS is in. As you can see, my NAS IP address is 192.168.10.8. Leave the exit node part in there. I'll explain that at the end as a bonus for you for sticking to this video all the way until end. This can also be very handy in some cases. Hit enter and enter your password to confirm if required. Now, if you go back to TailScale portal, you should see subnet and exit node under the NAS. This is because we have advertised both of them on our NAS. So if you hover over these, you'll know that these are not enabled yet. Let's go ahead and enable the subnet routes. Click on three dots next to NAS and edit route settings. As you can see, we have one subnet route available. Check the box next to it and click save. Alright, to test our Tailnet connection, let's switch the networks. For a proper test, I'll connect my PC with a hotspot from my mobile phone. That means I'll not have access to any local network devices. I'll disconnect the TailScale client. Now, if I try to access my NAS using its local or Tailnet IP address, it won't work and the connection will time out because I'm not on my local network anymore, and also I'm not connected to my Tailnet either because I have disconnected the client. I'll connect back to my Tailnet again using the client on my PC. So first, let's test the connection device on the same local network which does not have any TailScale client. And it has no direct visibility to my Tailnet whatsoever. So I'll try to access my Dream Machine Pro using its local IP address. So you can see now I can access my Dream Machine. Same way, I can access any network device within this subnet. This is because it's within the same local network my Synology NAS is in, and currently my Synology NAS is acting as a gateway for my Tailnet. Same goes for Synology NAS. Now if I need to access my NAS itself, I don't need to remember tailnet IP address anymore. I can access it using its local IP address as long as I'm connected to my tailnet from anywhere in the world. This is again because we have advertised the whole network and NAS is also part of the same network. Another advantage of TailScale is I can even access my NAS using File Explorer, which is exactly as if I'm sitting at home connected to my local network. It is recommended to disable the key expiry for subnet routers so that we don't have to re-authenticate on these devices periodically. To disable it, click on three dots next to your subnet router and click on Disable Key Expiry. You should see the status under your subnet router. So you have seen how powerful TailScale is. As I said earlier, on top of being super easy to set up, most importantly, is super secure as well. Before I wrap up this video, I'll show you another useful feature of Tailnet, which is Exit Node. We have already advertised the Exit Node when we ran the command earlier. So when we enable it, all my traffic will be routed through the Exit Node. It's same as full tunnel VPN basically, where the whole traffic passes through one node. So let's enable it from settings from our TailScale admin console. Again, go to Edit Route Settings. You should see your NAS as an exit node option. Enable it from there and then click Save. Now before we activate the exit node from our client on the PC, let's check my public IP address. This public IP address is not my home network IP address, as I'm connected through my mobile hotspot. Now open the TailScale client from the taskbar and select the exit node. In my case, it's TestNAS. Let's refresh the page again to check our new public IP address. Now this is my public IP address from my home network. This is because I have enabled my NAS in my tailnet as an exit node for my PC. So external IP address of that exit node will become external IP address of my PC as well. This can be handy in many scenarios. If you're in a public Wi-Fi, or let's say if you're traveling overseas and you want to log into your online banking account, your bank might flag it as it was not expecting that login from different unusual place. But if you are connected to Tailnet with exit node enabled, it will be as if you are on your home network. Alright, that's it for this video where we discussed about Tailnet, subnet router and the exit node. I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.